The person who was last up touched on sort of how society likes to declare certain ways of feeling better as inappropriate. And as she was touching on that, something activated within me, and it was this edginess that I love to release and allow myself to be that. And I really found ways of describing myself, such as I am like a penis, endowed with a seemingly endless capacity to create, but if I don't get excited, I don't work.
Sounds like a bumper sticker.
But I feel like
And we're appreciating the analogy. We are. We would not replace, but we want to add to the word excited with the word focused, because
yes.
The excitement that you're describing only comes through focus. In
yes.
other words, there was a book written some years ago, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill.
Uh-huh.
And Jerry taught from the book for a number of years. And there was a chapter on sexual transmutation. And that's exactly what that was talking about, it because it's something that most people understand, is that there's a singleness of purpose. There's a harmony of partnership. The basis or the components that made up the successful conclusion are all the same things that are necessary in the successful conclusion of anything. But the key element really is focus more than anything else. Yes. Consider it in this way, and we don't want to distract you too far from where you're headed, but we'll just be very careful with our choice of words here. Insert this into the conversation. And that is that what genius is attention to a subject.
Uh-huh.
Because law of attraction takes care of everything else. And what keeps things from gaining momentum is this way, this way, this way, this way, this way, this way. But when you are focused and not introducing resistance, then there is always that natural momentum building that you're talking about. Yes. So now we'll leave it to you.
So sometimes I sloppily focus on how a part of society or would sort of resist against the how do I give myself permission to be the penis more?
Well, we understand why there's a lot more to your reasoning in introducing it in this way. First of all, you are using an analogy that is more, you could not find an analogy that is experienced by more people and at the same time misunderstood by more people. Because just the subject of sexuality at all is something that is, for the most part, considered from a place of resistance.
Mm-hmm.
So it's by giving yourself permission to be who you are and to not give a rip what anybody else is thinking about it. And it really is, we're going to come back to the first thing we said to you, it's about focus. It's about being single-minded. You see, the reason that this subject is so good in relationship with the whole subject of deliberate creation or about leading-edge conversation at all is because most people are more concerned about what somebody else thinks about what they're doing or about what they're thinking than they are about their own alignment. And you have shown yourself, all of you have, if you've been in the midst of a sexual experience, you've shown yourself that you have to disregard everything else that's going on and selfishly do whatever it takes to get your mind in the place in order to accomplish what it is that you're wanting to accomplish in this moment. Mm-hmm. Yes? Yes?
Yeah. Yes.
And so in that disregarding of the rightness or the wrongness of it, in the disregarding of what somebody else is thinking about it, in other words, you've hit upon some things that are appropriate in the conversation of deliberate creation. We like your analogy.
Thank you.
We give you permission to be the penis. Of course, it is not our permission to give. We acknowledge your desire for it, and we are right behind you.
Pushing without pushing against.
Get out. Second one.